Hello everyone, RuneWraith here, and in this quick guide, I'm going to show you everything you need to know to take down RuneScape's newest mid-level boss, Scurrius the Rat King. Scurrius is RuneScape's newest mid-level boss. He helps players learn the fundamentals of higher-level PvM, like movement, prayer switching, and dealing with multiple monsters in a fight. Speaking of PvM fundamentals, if you haven't seen my video on the top 10 PvM skills you need to learn, you should definitely check it out. It's a great video. Now, it doesn't take much to take down Scurrius, so let's dive into the requirements. There are no quest or gear requirements to fight this boss, and it's specifically designed for mid-level PvMers. I'd recommend somewhere in the ballpark of 50 attack and defense, and a strength level of around 60. You'll also need 43 prayer, because you have to pray against all three combat styles during the fight. To get to Scurrius, teleport to Varrock's center and run northeast through the courtyard of the castle. You'll see the entrance to the Varrock sewers just east of the tree farming patch and southwest of the Varrock church. Once in the sewers, follow the larger brown rats and run east until you reach a large sewer gate that's been gnarled and torn open. You can start the fight with Scurrius by climbing through the broken bars. You can literally do this fight in rune armor, but your best strength bonus armor is gonna net you quicker kills. I believe the scythe is technically best in slot here, but please, for the love of God, don't waste scythe charges on this boss. The Ratbone Mace works wonderfully here because it yields additional experience and can one-tick the minions during the fight. It's created by combining a rune mace with Scurrius' spine, which is a very common drop from the boss at 1 in 33. Having some standard melee gear like a Fury, Helm of Netzanot, Fighter Torso, Fire Cape, Dragon Boots, Rune Gloves, and a Defender can make Scurrius kills buttery smooth. Now, Scurrius is a very straightforward fight. He'll attack with all three combat styles. His range and magic attacks all deal on impact instead of animation, so it gives players plenty of time to react and change their prayers accordingly. When prayed against correctly, Scurrius' attacks will never damage players. Scurrius' melee attack comes fast and can be identified by Scurrius striking the player with his tail. It deals a max hit of 13. His mage attack looks like blue lightning and can hit a max hit of 14. And finally, the range attack looks like a green blob, but is actually just a piece of moldy cheese and can hit a max of 13. Now, Scurrius has two special attacks. His first special attack will have him summon rubble, which will fall all around the arena. Players only need to avoid tiles with shadows underneath them. The rubble does not damage players in an AoE manner, but there will always be a piece of rubble which spawns on the player's current tile when the attack is fired. My only advice here is just to be cautious of when and how you click back on the boss. The boss moves, so you can easily get dragged into another rubble spot or path from underneath the boss onto other dangerous tiles. Now, Scurrius' second special attack will have him summon a league of rats to attack the player with melee. The rats hit 0 to 1 through prayer and are fairly accurate. Luckily, players always hit their max hit against them, and if using a ratbone weapon, players will incur no attack delay, so they can quickly dispatch all of the rats. The fight takes place in three phases. In phase one, Scurrius will attack with melee and occasionally use his rubble attack. At 80% of his health, he'll move towards a food pile to heal up. During phase two, Scurrius will heal 5 to 10 hit points up to 5 times, and use only his range, magic, rat summon, and rubble attacks on the player. After eating from all three food piles or reaching 30% health, whichever comes first, players will enter the final phase of the fight. Scurrius will move to the center of the room and attack players with range or magic exclusively at a faster rate, while still being able to summon rats and rubble. The general strategy here is to pray melee during the first phase, pray mage or range accordingly while Scurrius eats in phase two, kill the rats when they spawn, and use your specs during phase 3 to quickly dispatch the boss. Sounds like a lot, but there's really not much to this fight, so check out this example kill. Okay, just to prove how easy this boss actually is, I'm going in here completely naked with nothing but the bone mace. I'm also brewing my combat stats down from 99 to around 61 so that I can kind of simulate what it would be like for mid-level players. I've just got two prayer potions, a couple tuners, and a dragon dagger as my special attack weapon. So we're starting out the fight in phase 1. And we want to pray melee during this first phase because he's almost exclusively going to use his melee and rebel attacks. So we just want to watch out for those shadows on the ground while praying melee. In this case, you can see that I'm flicking him. You can easily get into this rhythm if you're into saving prayer. So now we've got Scurrius just about below 80%, so he's gonna go into phase 2. This is where he goes to a random cheese pile, uses exclusively range magic, rat special, and debris special, and he'll eat and heal a little bit of his hit points. Now, fun fact, after this fight is over, every 10 minutes, you can actually eat from these same cheese piles to restore all of your health back to full, helping to prolong your trips. Phase 2 isn't much different from phase 1. I pray range when it's a green attack, and I pray mage when it's a blue attack. Other than that, I'm just keeping out a lookout for rebel, and I'm on my toes and prepared for when he summons rats. So here he summoned rats. You can see since I'm using the bone mace, I'm able to one-tick all of these rats and dispatch them very, very quickly. They really shouldn't be a threat if you stay on top of them. Alright, one more rat spawn, and we have Scurrius under 30% of his health, which means we have just entered phase 3. Now he'll exclusively use his range, magic, rubble, and rat spawn attacks. He will no longer melee you. So here, we just want to switch our prayers accordingly, pull out our spec weapon, spec him as much as we can, and make sure that we stay on top of praying range and magic, because if we do that, we shouldn't be taking any damage. When he does spawn the rats, we want to try to alternate between switching prayers and finishing off those rats as quickly as we can. Other than that, the fight is pretty straightforward. Avoid the rebel, kill the rats, switch your prayers appropriately, and you'll finish off Scurrius in no time. And that's a full example kill of Scurrius in budget gear with very low stats. So I hope you guys have learned something about this boss. You can see I can eat from the food pile over here once the fight is done to replenish my health every 10 minutes. And that's all there is to it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe as it really helps my channel grow. Thank you and have a great day.